Hi, this is Stephen Kenworthy, and I have autism. Well, autism doesn't really do much to my driving. There's just one thing, and that is that occasionally, whenever my friends say to me, Barack Obama is the president of the United States and he ruined this economy, that usually encourages me to floor the gas pedal of a car and make me go really fast. Like, sometimes I go 20 to 30 miles per hour faster than what I originally was going at. Does some other things to me, like it gives me an obsessive compulsive disorder, which is where I need to check things regularly. Like, I check the door constantly to make sure it's locked. Even if the door is locked, I keep pushing down the switch just to make sure it's locked, and it's because of my autism. Normal people would not have this problem. It's like I keep checking the door to make sure it's locked because I want to be sure of everything. And on top of that, it takes me a while to start up the car. But apart from that, I'm a really good driver, so autism doesn't really do much. Things regularly, check the mirrors too much. So it's not really that severe. Basically, what I've been doing in my past is I do a lot of things called hand motions, which is where I basically use my hands to make images that are in my head. It's very complicated to understand, but I do all of these hand motions, and usually it's caused when a certain subject is mentioned and the subject is really weird, or it's something I don't understand, or it's something that's too complicated, or it's just a subject that builds up a lot of energy in me, and that energy is just so strong that as a result, I can't hold it in my body, so I start acting crazy, and I end up doing all of these hand motions, making the images in my hands. Currently, I am undecided as to what job I really want when I grow up, but what I'd like to do is, I'm very interested in history, mathematics, and economics. I really wish that when I grow up I could get a job like as a history teacher, because I'm very interested in history. I've done very well at school in history classes, like on the Regents exam for global history, I got a 95, so, and also on the U.S. history regents, I got a 98. So I really wish that maybe I could be a history teacher, because I could teach people about history, and then I could, teaching is also a very good job, because you could get summer vacation off. It might affect me getting a job, because autism has really made my mind different from others. Like, it's disabled me, kind of. I'm very slow to do everything. Or if I'm like filling out paperwork, it might take me longer to think, so I might take a long time to get everything done, but I'd be very good at my job. I'd know what to do, I'd know everything, but it would just take me longer to get things done because I have autism, and because also I have obsessive compulsive disorder, and I'd be constantly checking everything, making sure it was right, and spending too much time trying to check everything. That's how autism would basically impact my life. So when I went to Camp Playland, which was during the summertime of 2006 and 2007, yeah, I went to Camp Playland for 2 years. I got bullied a lot when I was there by most of the kids. I don't know what was wrong with them. They were very mean people. Basically, they would see me doing all of my crazy hand motions, jumping up and down, going crazy, and they thought I was a weird kid. And because they saw me acting weird, they took advantage of me for this. They constantly would hit me, they teased me a lot, called me all kinds of bad names, they said bad words to me. They were just very mean to me in general. And it was basically because of the fact that I was autistic and I looked strange to them. I got bullied by many people at Camp Playland. I was really surprised to see so many people who were against me. The counselors basically did nothing to stop them. Basically, the counselors were like 18, 19-year-old people. They were just there because they wanted to get paid. So they got involved when they felt like getting involved. But most of the time when they got involved, it was when I was retaliating against the bullies. It's like the bullies would throw stuff at me, like checker pieces, or they would bump into me or hit me on purpose. And it looked like an accident, but I knew it was really purposely. Then I would try to hit them back, or I'd try to shove them or punch them. I mean, who do they think they are? I'm defending myself, for Christ's sake. These bullies are bothering me. This made me feel really pissed off. I wanted to leave that camp. Okay, there is this kid who goes to the same school as me. His name is Gianfranco Siciliano. He's a kid I like very much. I really admire him and look up to him. He's a special ed kid just like me. He's in the Foundations of Learning class with all of the special ed students. However, I don't feel that because of that, he's really a bad kid. I feel he's very nice because he's kind to everybody. He works very hard and does his homework. Often I say to him, hey, Gianfranco, you want to hang out? And he's like, no, I'm busy tonight. And he's just been very nice and kind to me. And because he's such a nice kid, occasionally I think about him and I go really crazy because the fact that he's such a good kid builds up such excitement in me. And I do a hand motion where I make images of him in my head. I make images of his head, his eyes, and everything. I'm just making pictures of him with my hands whenever I do this hand motion called Gianfranco. And you can also see that when I do the hand motion, I'm really happy, for I'm thinking about how much I like him. One of my best friends is Alexander Kiggins. Alexander Kiggins is his name. Me and him go back very long. We know each other very well. I've known Alex for like over 8 years now, and I've been in the same class with him all throughout my middle school years. He's very nice and kind to me. He's very understanding. Every time I do my hand motions, every time I act crazy, go weird, normal people will think I'm a weirdo, but Alex is not that type of person. He's understanding to me and very kind. He understands that I have problems and he copes with me all the time. Basically, what happens is he understands my problems and he doesn't make any jokes about it or laugh at me that much. Or if he does, he doesn't mock me in any way. No matter what, we are friends.
My life at school has always been very tough because of the fact that I have been autistic. When I first entered school, it was a new thing. Basically, what happened was I was treated differently from the average kid because when I went to school, I was in a class where all of the kids were studying and they would take their lessons in small cubicles. Basically, when I went to school, I wasn't like, me and my classmates were not like a regular class where all of the desks are in rows. You sit at the desks and then listen to the teacher at the front of the class talk. Basically, we would have our own cubicles where we would sit alone and not have anybody to talk to. We would do our work and then the teachers would come to us and give us our lessons one-on-one. And that's how I learned how to read and write. So, I'm in mainstream classes now, but I still do have occasional extra help. And that's how my life has been at school.
Steven inspires a lot of people, I believe. He's inspired me in many ways throughout my life, and I will always be friends with Steven Kenworthy.